So.
Just say hello.
Just say hello. So, hello guys.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
私は Nara です。よろしくお願いします。
私は Jakemo です。
Salam alaikum.
Salam.
Okay, so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Again.
Again.
So, how have you been?
I've been good.
Yeah, how have you been? I'm really good. I became a Muslim.
Oh, hey, mashallah.
What's your name?
My name is Dina. I'm from America.
My name is Nora. I am from France.
My name is Rukaya. I'm from France. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Today's topic is hijabis who work in Korea. Yeah, I think many people told me that, oh, can hijabis work in Korea, or are there any prejudice or stereotype? So I want to ask you some questions that people wonder. The first question is, what is your job?
I teach English to elementary schoolers in the countryside, conversational English in particular.
Something new.
Dina teacher.
I find a part-time job as a barista in Gangnam. It took me like maybe 2 weeks to find it. Two or three weeks. I think I was lucky.
Yeah,
thanks
really
God.
Lucky.
I had several positions in Korea. For 1 month, I was a cafe manager. 9 months, I was a digital project manager in a trading company in Gangnam. And I also had I was cleaning team in a guest house also. Yeah, I had several jobs in Korea.
You had a lot of jobs.
Yeah, wow. I tried several positions in Korea.
Master of career. Many people asked me this question. Was it hard to get a job in Korea as a hijabi? How do you think?
Well, the job itself, they didn't really look at my hijab. They just looked at if I met the qualifications of the job. No one mentioned anything about my hijab. The only question they asked about my appearance was how many ear piercings I have.
Really?
Yeah.
Doesn't they care about your hijab?
No, I told them. I was like, well, you can't even really see my piercings most of the time. I'm like, I have 6. And they're like, oh. I'm like, but you can't see all of them. It's like scandalous to have 6 ear piercings. Korea has freedom of religion. So technically, they're not allowed to discriminate against you because of your hijab or because of your religion. It's really more, at least with my experience, do you meet the qualification? Jobs are hard to find anyways.
Yeah, anyways.
The only time I have problems with my hijab when it comes to jobs is if it's like acting or modeling. Then people are like, oh, can you take that off? And obviously I say no. Like, this is part of the package.
As a model too.
I have to admit it's a little bit hard. For me, thanks God, it wasn't really hard for me because I find a boss who lived in America, so he was like open-minded. He asked me first, what is that in your head? Do you have any religion? Are you Muslim? And I said, yeah. And he was like, oh, that's okay. Okay, I was just wondering. Sometimes they ask you the question just because they want to know that they're not racist or anything.
And that's it.
Yeah, that's it. And he said, oh, okay, oh, it's pretty.
I think, honestly, it's hard, actually, as a hijabi. I was really blessed and grateful that my former boss, he was French. So they didn't ask that question, like, do you wear the hijab or anything? So I was just, like, hired upon my skill. So I am expert in digital marketing. I am expert in managing project. That's why the main reason they hire me, not because I am Muslim and I wear the hijab. If I apply for Korean company, like apart from being hijabi, is can I speak Korean? I think that's the main point in Korea.
That's the main point.
If I
not
target,
the hijab thing.
Yeah, not the hijab, but maybe you could like happen because you know they will ask you like, how about hijik? Do you drink alcohol? If we do hijik, do you eat pork or something like that? The question might pop up, but. It's difficult, but it's challenging everywhere. So I don't think Korea is a special case.
Okay, so the main point was you can speak Korean or not.
Ah, 조금만 한국말 조금만 할 수 있어요.
잘하네요. I'm so curious about that. I'm so curious that how do your co-workers treat you in your job?
They're very nice to me.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Ooh. No one's mean to me at all. I'm the youngest. I'm the mangnae. I think the only thing is like my principal. Likes me a little too much and so
too much
and so I'm like always like there's a line you stay
boundary.
Over there
yeah
they're all really nice. People feed me a lot because Korean culture involves a lot of food,
right.
People feed me all the time.
Iko mogo.
The only thing is sometimes I'm like, oh, I can't eat that because you know there's like spammers and they have this kimbap. I'm like, I can't, there's spam in it. Thank you though.
Too nice
Yeah, they're really nice.
How about your students? Like, how do your students treat you Like, I'm so curious. Yeah,
they just ask weird questions about everything. Where are you from? Are you married? Do you have a boyfriend? Do you have any kids? What's on your head? What color is your hair? Teacher, it's hot. Why are you wearing long sleeves? Like, my older kids don't question me. My younger kids are the more... Usually, I change my scarf color every day, obviously. So kids are more interested. Ooh, teacher, what color are you gonna wear tomorrow?
Yeah. That's their question.
Yeah. Tomorrow, can you wear the blue one? I'm like, okay, I'll wear the blue one. I'll wear it for you, Hyerin.
Okay, that's cool. Oh, I'm glad to hear that. At least they don't like judge that because of your hijab.
Well, they're kids. I mean, as long as you're nice to them, they'll learn that you're a nice person, and they might even think, oh, maybe other people that look like you are nice people.
I think that's good education to them, I think. Like, hiring hijabis in school, I think it can be a really good education for students. Diversity.
Yeah. Yeah, my students, at first they thought I was from India or Malaysia or something, because they thought only people from those countries wear hijab. Yeah. And I'm like, no, I'm from America. They're like, what? People in America look like you? Mm. Like, people in America look like everything.
My coworker were really kind. I had the chance to make my prayers on time when I was working. I say to my coworkers, okay, it's time to pray. And she tell me, oh, it's okay, you can go. It's like only 5 minutes. My coworker were really nice.
Well, they were kind. And in my company, I work for the most 9 months. My boss is French, so we speak in French. You know, everyone make effort to understand each other, so it's fine. And I don't think they treat me like badly. They were fine.
That's cool.
And most of the interns, they were younger than me. And I was the daddy. So, you can't really say much. I really realized work culture is different.
Hierarchy.
Yeah, yes, hierarchy is really
so different.
Thank you, my boss.
Next question was, are people biased toward you because of your hijab in here?
Yeah. When it comes to my job, no. I'm sure some people experience it, but I personally, in Korea, have not experienced it. In America, yes. In Korea, no. Yes. People are curious.
Actually, Korea is good for Muslims. Food is difficult, but exact food.
You can live here for a month until you starve. I'm just kidding.
Not really discrimination or offended, but I think what I felt, it's maybe as Muslim people, there are not a lot of Muslim here. They don't really want to mix, because as they know that Islam really strict religion, and as they drink and stuff like this, so they don't want to offend you, so they just stay far. I don't blame them, because they don't really know, but I think step by step they're gonna know more about Muslim people. Of course, religion, it's a part of us, but we're first human, especially as a Muslim girl, because they will always pushing you to take off your hijab. But you have to be strong. Nobody can make us take it off, because it's for God. Yeah. If you don't respect what you decide, you're gonna lose yourself. I think so.
I think they might have some prejudice, but they don't show it. Or maybe, they kind of just ignore it, because at work, I'm supposed to work. Let me see if it's outside of work, we go to cafe, we discuss, maybe the vibe is different. But at work, we are so busy with the task we are supposed to do. So at work, you should just work. Like, why do you have to worry about, I wear the hijab? No, work is work.
Okay, focus on work.
Yeah.
Okay, so my last question is, do you have any message for people who want to work in Korea but who are afraid because of their hijab? Because I got a lot of messages that were afraid of because their hijab.
Like, at least for me, in my comments or they send me messages, can I find a job as a hijabi? I think it's all in your mind. It's not really can you find a job as a hijabi. It's like, can you find a job? Why are you limiting yourself? Like, I can't do this because I have a hijab. No, you can't do this because you don't have the qualifications. Get your qualifications and then you can do it. Don't hurt yourself and make yourself handicapped for no reason. Yeah. You can do it. Get your qualifications together and good luck. You can do it. Really want to, I think.
Yeah. We believe you.
Yes.
If you want to come here and work, just come and work and try. If it doesn't work, it's okay. So you don't have to be scared. Korean people are really nice and they're really welcoming and warm people. So I think you don't have to hesitate coming here, really.
First of all, I would say, you know, prepare your trip. Like, you know, it's not easy. You can't just come to Korea and be like, okay, I'll come to Korea, I'll meet my oppa. And like, no, that's not true. I was French, so I had the opportunity to come with a working holiday visa. Others can come with like work visa. The company can, you know, sponsor them or everything. You must prepare your trip. Like, if you want to come, you know, first, if you have the budget to do it, learn the language. Maybe do scholarship, you know, you can do everything, but don't be afraid, because Korea, it's a country, but there is other country as well. Like, I came to Korea because I like Korea, but there is so many countries and so many opportunities around. So if you want to do it, you know, just say bismillah. Get, you know, first, like, write a project. Okay, what do I need to do? Do I need to save money? Do I have any contacts? Because, of course, you must have some friends that know friends, that cousins or anything that lives in Korea. And so many people, they are reachable on internet, on Facebook, on Instagram. You can ask many questions on LinkedIn too, like the, you know, the job platform. So get as much as information. And if you feel you're ready, then just go. If yes. not, you know, it's not bad. So it's not so bad too in your own country. France is not a bad country, but I just prefer to try another adventure, another journey in Korea. Mm. Alhamdulillah, here I am.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, thank you for saying your message. It was really touched. Okay, thank you so much.
You're
so
welcome.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye, guys. Thank
bye.
You.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.